So good afternoon po ulit. So we'll now proceed po for the Article 7. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. Okay? So the seventh article discusses two things, the second coming of Christ and the judgment day. So ito yung mga tipong iniiwasan na o ayaw nating iwasan, pero yung iba they are really anticipating what will happen. Okay? So judgment day. So there will be particular judgment immediately after death, because when we're talking about judgment, we're talking about two things: particular judgment and universal judgment. Okay? In this article po, the creed refers to the general judgment or the universal judgment, which takes place after all men are reunited with their bodies, the good unto the life everlasting, and in their glorified body, just like Jesus Christ, and the evil one unto the everlasting punishment. So yung mga masasama, in their immortal but unglorified bodies. So whether or not those living on earth at this final hour will undergo physical death is not defined at or is not defined as a matter of faith. But in the revelation itself, in Thessalonians and Corinthians, they're talking about not all in the end of times, when the second coming of Christ, not all people will die. So if, for example, here in the painting of Michelangelo, para silang nilift up ng Diyos yung mga ibang nabubuhay, those just people. So there are many symbolism here. Some of them are holding rosaries. So they were lifted up by God. Okay? So when you say second coming of Christ, we're talking about parousia in Greek or adventus in Latin. So medyo, we all know that there are many things or stories behind the end of times. Okay. So during the final hour of, or the second coming, or before the second coming of Christ, the glorious Messiah's coming is suspended at every moment of history until his recognition by all Israel. When you say by all Israel, we're not talking about the country only, about the Israel. So every ends of the earth, they must recognize that Jesus is the Lord. He is the Messiah. So the church must pass through a final persecution. Ito yung medyo nakakatakot at the end of times. Persecution, religious deception by Antichrist, iniquity, and unleashing of evil. So nakakatakot in a sense kung abutan man tayo ng end of times. Okay? So persecution, which is already happening since the beginning or since the start of Christianity. Even until this time, di ba? Especially during the times of Islamic State ng mga ISIS, di ba? There is a great persecution for Christians. We all know a lot of people have died. Okay? So when you talk about judgment, we will be judged according to the secrets of our hearts. Okay? Kung ano talaga yung nasa puso natin. So how we use God's grace to save our souls. So we talk about graces. So maraming forms of graces. Okay? But we'll see if we can expand more about these graces. Yung attitude about our neighbor, okay, will disclose acceptance or refusal of grace and divine love. Oh. An example nito. There are cases that we have the opportunity to help other people. Okay? This is good for us, actually. Not only good for the person that you're going to help to. Because this grace, by helping other people, you're giving some sort of goodness or sabihin na natin points into heaven. Okay? But we all know, not because of our works only, that gives us ticket to heaven. Because this is the gift of God. Okay? Now, this is just one example of grace. So, but when we reject the grace in this life, dito sa mundong ito, One already judges oneself. It recedes according to one's work and can even condemn oneself for all eternity by rejecting the spirit of love. So, we talk about, again, the term love or charity. So, love. Again, what is God? God is love. God is merciful. God is justice. Balik na naman tayo doon. So, we are judged according to our hearts by loving our neighbors. So, what did the saints about at the end of times? According to Jesus to Sister Saint Faustina, right, before I come as a just judge, I first open a wide door of my mercy. Okay? He who refuses to pass through the door of my mercy must pass through the door of my justice. So, malino yan. So, in line pa rin yan when we talk about this refusal of grace. So, pasok na pasok. So, we already have this clear message from the divine mercy. So, eto na. Eto na tayo. So, we are already in the end of times. Ano naman sabi ni Saint Bridget of Sweden? What did the saints about the end of times? Before Antichrist comes, the portals of the faith will be open to great number of pagans. So, alam mo na naman na natin na before we become Christians, we are all pagans. Diba? So we are all pagans before. So we have to reach out our brothers and sisters. If you have the opportunity to spread the gospel, this is part of that grace. Okay? Because this is part of the mission of us being a Christian. So hindi lang to mission ng mga pare, ng mga pastor, diba? Mga katikes na katulad ko. We are all part of that mission. As a baptized Christian. Okay? So, when we talk about six eschatological questions, we talk about the death, judgment, and final destiny. Okay? So, ano ba yan? And these are the things that we're going to be asked when we die or when we are going to be judged. Did you give food for the hungry? Did you give water to the thirsty? Did you clothe the naked? Did you welcome the strangers? Did you care for the sick? Did you visit the prisoners? So these are all works of mercy or your corporal works of mercy. So diyan pala, yan yung part na i-judge sa atin. Pagdating ng end of times or if we died early, our particular judgment. So the Father has given all judgment to the Son, yet the Son did not come to judge, but to save and to give life he has in himself. Again, by rejecting the grace in this life, one already judges oneself, receives according to one's works, and can even condemn oneself for all eternity by rejecting the spirit of love. So paulit-ulit yan. So kung paano tayo magmahal. Unfortunately, not all of us knows how to love, diba? Even myself, I'm having a hard time loving other people, diba? I remember one guy, sino ba yun? Hindi siya magpapakamatay sa asawa niya, diba? Diba?
Lipat na ako lang.
Ay, hindi ko alam eh. Diba? So, we are going to be judged. Okay? So, we have to be careful. We have to think about how to love other people. So, in a sense, yun yung message doon. From thence he shall come forth to judge the living and the dead. So, the summary of this is to, it affirms the second coming of Christ, the end of the world, be it to be its judge. Okay? Judgment day, day of reckoning, doomsday. So, we can imagine that one. So, again, it is a general judgment or universal judgment for all. Eighth article. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the third person in the Holy Trinity. Okay? So, we talk about that and the manifestation of Holy Spirit and the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Okay? But in terms of defining the gifts of the Holy Spirit, we're not going to expand that one because of the time constraint. So this Article 8, this dogma affirms that the eternal procession of the third person of the Holy Trinity, revealed explicitly by Christ himself, okay, which will be further developed at the Council of Nicaea and Constantinople I, okay, in refutation of the heresy of Macedonius. Kasi yung Macedonius is one of the earliest, let's say, Christians before, who doesn't believe in the divinity of Holy Spirit, okay? Who denied that, as part of the three divine persons, okay? Rejecting the eternal procession of the Holy Ghost, the Sanctifier, okay? So remember, our life, salvation revolves around three persons. The Father, which creates, or the Planner, the Son, which is the Redeemer, and the Accomplisher, and the Holy Spirit, which is the one who sanctifies or applier of salvation. Okay? Again, the Father is the source, the Son is the means, and the Holy Spirit is the effector of the salvation. So it is He who convicts, convinces, and converts all of us. That's why we're calling the Holy Spirit, di ba? Meron tayong song, meron tayong hymn, "Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love." And we also call the Holy Spirit so that when we read the Holy Bible, we will be able to understand the message for us. Not to interpret the Bible, but the message where it's giving to us. Yun yung kailangan natin. Okay. How do we prove that the Holy Spirit is God? First, in the creation, di ba? The Word of God and His breath are the origin of the being of life of every creature. It belongs to the Holy Spirit, the rule, the sanctify, and to animate every creature. And during the incarnation of Christ, if the Holy Spirit were not God, Mary would have conceived Jesus on her own. But this is impossible, of course. Punta si God, di ba? Kasi at that time, si Jesus kailangan maging man. Third, baptism of Jesus. If the Holy Spirit were not God, to say that He came down like a dove would be senseless. So it's, in a sense, ridiculous, di ba? Alam naman natin during the time of Jesus' baptism, it is the symbol of anointing by God. So the Holy Spirit is the one who applies that sanctification or that anointing, should I say. In the fourth, the Pentecost. Remember, before Jesus' ascension, He will not leave us abandoned, di ba? He said He will send His Holy Spirit upon us to be with us always. So 50 days after the resurrection, the Holy Spirit appeared in tongues of fire through the apostles, di ba? And to those other people who were there, including Mary Magdalene and si Mama Mary, nandun, di ba? So those are the what we call, or the beginning, or the birth of Christianity. Why is the Holy Spirit proceeding from the Father and the Son? Okay, to say that the Holy Spirit proceeds from the Father and the Son means to profess that He is the same divine substance. So, reference there is CCC 245. Since the Holy Spirit is eternal without beginning or end, just like Jesus, just like God the Father, He was not created but proceeded from the Father. Okay? Confess in 381 Anno Domini, the First Council of Constantinople. Question? Hola. Okay. And in the Second Ecumenical Council and the Son, so proceeds from the Father and the Son, Filioque, by Pope St. Leo I, confessed it dogmatically in 447. So it came to recognize and receive the symbol in 451 at the Council of Chalcedon. So reason is therefore the eternal order of divine persons in their consubstantial communion. Ano ibig sabihin? Yung proceedings or yung order. It doesn't mean the Holy Spirit came from Jesus Christ. No. It's the order of succession only. Okay? Unfortunately, etong filioque na yan, is one of the reason why, or the last straw that breaks the camel's back, di ba? Yung pagkakahiwalay ng Roman Catholic and the Orthodox Church. Actually, hindi pa siya Orthodox. Yun yung Great Schism. Yan yung naging cost nung pagkakahiwalay natin because of this filioque. They don't want to put this one, but because the Pope is under the Roman Catholic and they don't like to be included in the Apostles' Creed ba or Nicene Creed, they separated the ways. Yan. Hopefully, magkabalikan na talaga yung Orthodox and the Catholic Church. Okay? So when I believe or we believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and Giver of Life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. Ito yung part na yung filioque sa Nicene Creed. Who together with the Father and the Son is to be adored and glorified, who was spoken by the prophets. So unfortunately, because of this filioque, nagka-separate ang nagkaroon ng Great Schism sa Catholic Church. So why is the Holy Spirit called the Paraclete? Okay? The Holy Spirit is called the Paraclete. A Greek word means consoler or advocate. Because in the times of trial and suffering, the Holy Spirit is on our side to console and bring us peace. So you can imagine before, during the time of the apostles, they were being consoled by the Holy Spirit. During the time of persecution also here, in the modern times, the Holy Spirit will be upon us to console us. Especially if we're defending our faith, di ba? Because we are brought to trial before men or God, the Holy Spirit will be on our side as a defense lawyer. The Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. So kahit hindi ka magsalita, yung Holy Spirit na magtra-translate ng mga prayers niyo to God. Okay? And He is called the Spirit of Truth because the Holy Spirit will lead us into all truths and will glorify Christ. Remember, sinabi ni Jesus Christ, there's so much things I want to reveal to you, but you cannot take it. So ang Holy Spirit is the one who's teaching us, clarifying us the way of Christ, teachings of Christ. So Holy Spirit talaga. That's why we need to call upon the Holy Spirit. He will prove the world wrong about sin, righteousness, and judgment. So He is the one reminding us what to do and ano ba yung right way. Okay? So, when we talk about the Holy Spirit, we talk about the gifts of the Holy Spirit. So, what are the gifts or charisms of the Holy Spirit? Are there what we call spiritual graces? Okay. So, when we're, especially us, di ba? All of you are, most of you are lectors here, di ba? In my part, I'm catechist, or also at the same time, Eucharistic minister, di ba? So each person is entrusted with a particular charism, for instance. Saint Francis was given the charism of poverty, while Saint Dominic that of preaching. So mainly, this one is the seven gifts or the important charism of the Holy Spirit, okay, bestowed by God. So you can find it in Isaiah chapter 11, verse 2 to 3. We have wisdom, understanding, counsel, strength, knowledge, piety, fear of the Lord, or yung oneness, yung ibang tawag sa fear of the Lord is yung parang ano ka, yung nauusam ka sa kapangyarihan ng Diyos. Yun. So, not all of us are given this kind of gifts, di ba? So, maybe, just maybe, ha? Maybe I have the wisdom and knowledge, but I don't have the piety. I don't have the fear of the Lord. I don't have the counsel. Sinasabi ko sa wife ko, oh, you have the counsel, the gift of counsel, I don't have. So if there's something to do with conflict or arguments to give proper guidance, I turn to my wife, not to me, because I don't have that kind of gift. So maybe others have the proper gift of strength, di ba? Or understanding. So, depende yan. So, kung ano yung bibigay sa inyo ng Holy Spirit. Depending on the circumstances. Okay? Others, you can, ano, there's a variety of gifts also. Oh, we have prophecy, which can tell about what will happen in the future. Serving, mga nagsaserve, teaching, exhortation, giving, yung mga generous people. Leadership, yung mga officers natin dyan. Mercy, oh, words of wisdom, words of knowledge, yun yung mga sinabi. Gifts of healing, like in the case of yung sa Batangas before, na namatay na, si Father Fernando. He has the gifts of healing, miracles. Like in the case of the Fatima children. Prophecy again, distinguishing spirits, between spirits. Eto, gusto ko yan. Gusto ko mahilig ako sa mga mystery. Gifts of tongues. Unfortunately, hindi ko ma-validate ko yung mga gifts of tongue na nangyari sa church datin. If it's correct or if it, I cannot really validate if it's true or not. Huh? No offense. Interpretation of tongues. Kasi those who have the gifts of tongues, they can, what do you call that one? They can speak in a different language that is not being learned. Okay? They suddenly can speak. For example, I don't know how to speak in Latin. Then I could just converse it in Latin. And then other people, the gifts of interpretation of tongues, they can understand you. Okay? They have the apostles, the prophets. So these are the kinds of other gifts. Of course, administration, evangelist, pastor, service again, whoever speaks. So there are a variety of gifts that is given to each person. So hindi naman lahat pwede magkaroon ng gifts of healing. Wala nang i-heal, di ba? Hindi naman pwedeng lahat. Prophecy, lahat na lang tayo mag-prophesize. Pagalingan na lang tayo, di ba? Hindi pwedeng ganun. So, Article 8, I believe in the Holy Spirit. So, this part reminds that the believer that God exists in three persons, the Holy Trinity. Again, God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Okay? All of them are equal, but the Godhead goes to God the Father. Article 9, lapit na tayo matapos. Okay. Talks about the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints. Or I believe in the Holy Catholic Church and the communion of saints. So we're talking about, again, the communion. Talks about church and nature and mission of the church. How to become a Catholic. Characteristics of one true church. Okay, ito dapat malaman ninyo as a Catholic because every now and then, we are being attacked by other Christian denomination. If you cannot explain this one, you'll have a doubt, just like what I experienced long time ago. Okay? So, ano pa yung nangyari sa akin? Check ako, attend ako dito, attend ako doon. Try to understand their church, their denomination, their sect. So, by the grace of God, nakabalik ako sa Catholic Church. Okay? So we have to understand our Catholic faith properly. And of course, the communion of saints. Ito na. The symbol of? Kano yung symbol yan? Pope. Yes. So the church is the assembly of those who believe in Jesus Christ, who are baptized and who are in communion with the Pope. So importante yan. Hindi pwedeng you are baptized in Catholic Church but you are not in communion with the Pope. Later on, we'll explain why. So the church is not simple building or simply a building or institution, but a community of believers. So even a short 3-5 people, it's a community of believers na yan. Okay? So the creed concludes with the profession of faith in the Holy Catholic Church, followed by the way of extension with that of the communion of saints. So the church is not identical to the communion of saints here on earth. Okay, kasi sila church triumphant na, tayo church militant. Because we are struggling to become good, to become perfect. Okay, unlike them in heaven. Because in this life, the church is composed of those who are in grace. In this sense, they are saints. Siyempre, meron naman ditong ano eh, saints talaga in on earth. Pero bibihira, di ba? And sinners who have lost grace but still members of the church. Okay? And also the dead members. So tatandaan nyo nga pala, we are the church militant, the church penitent, those who are in purgatory, and the church triumphant, which is the saints in heaven. So what is the nature of the church? The very nature of its church is its mission. Again, yeah, ulitin ko sa inyo, to make all disciples of men. So medyo nakakahiya tayo. The other, our brothers and sisters in Protestant denomination, they are more, what do you call that? Tawag dito, mas active. Mas, ano yung tawag nito? Yung, ano yung tawag nyo? Hindi lang proactive. Yung,
aggressive.
Aggressive, yun. Aggressive sila in terms of calling or making people as disciples of Christ. Dapat tayo rin, di ba? Mas may gift sila ng in terms of strength, di ba? Kahit mahuli sila dyan. Di ba? What is the mission of church? The mission of church is to establish among all peoples the kingdom of God. Or what we call auto-basileia. Ano may auto-basileia? Okay? Sabi dito, si Origen is one of the church earliest church father. Okay? He said, Jesus is auto-basileia. That means the kingdom in person. Okay? The kingdom of God in the knitting together of divinity, of humanity that was sundered at even. Kasi dati, nung panahon ni Adam and Eve, they are holy. They have a glorious body. Oh, for take note on that. They have a glorious body, not like this. Okay? The reason why they have this body now, because at the time of the first disobedience, the original sin. Okay? That's because of that one. And we lost that glorious body. Because we are intended to become just like angels. Okay? So, what are you supposed to be do? By the way, auto basileia, when you say kingdom in person, again, ano ba yung pag sinabing kingdom in person? Kasi si Jesus Christ, it's like the kingdom of God is already here on earth. Ito na yung church. Because Christ already came here. Sasabihin mo rin, the kingdom of God is not yet here. Because it's about to come. Okay? We're still waiting for second coming of Christ. So it's not here, but not here. So it's two meaning. Okay? We're here because nandiyan si yung sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. So it's here. It's not here because we are about to come again because with our glorious body. So it has a double meaning. Okay? Just to be clear, huwag kayo malilito doon. Auto basileia, the kingdom in person. So what are we need to do? Evangelization. Para sa mission of Christ, mission of the church, is the process of proclaiming the gospel to all peoples. It begins with kerygma, or the preaching or proclamation. Then, we'll talk about, or it continues with the process of catechumenate. Yung ginagawa namin sa adult catechism, those converting from non-Catholic to become a Catholic. So, catechumenate sila. Then, we have the sacramentalization. It's a process of sanctifying our life by means of sacraments. Of course, to become a Catholic, you have to be baptized. It's the first requirement to become or to enter to become member of the church. Then we have other sacraments, the Holy Eucharist, the confirmation, the confession, the marriage or holy order. Of course, the last one, it's the last rites, yung anointing of the sick. So, these are the things that make us holy. Okay? Or to become holy. So remember also, going back here, the thunder of Eden, kasi nga, di ba, after the first original sin, we lost our glorious body. And that thundering caused from disobedience to original sin, it also caused different kinds of sin. Ano ba yan? Sample, pride or vanity, lust, anger or wrath, sloth or laziness, gluttony, greed or avarice, and envy. So, marami ako niyan. Huwag na kayong makihihalo pa. Okay? So, dapat yan ang bawasan natin. And each one, each category has also different varieties. Okay? Ayoko na sabihin, baka sabihin nyo, malaman nyo yung kasalanan ko. Okay? So, each one of us, this kind of sinfulness. So, it really depends on your weakness. Kaya nga, sabi ko sa inyo, if assuming we die today and without mortal sin, so probably it really depends what level we are in the purgatory. Because we are all saved. We have chance to go to heaven. Okay? That's why we're trying to struggle. So what are the requirements to be part of the Catholic Church? First, gaya ng earliest Christians or earliest pagans, they need to first to believe in Jesus Christ. You have to profess by Saint Peter, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. So of course, after professing that you believe in Jesus Christ, you need to be baptized. Not only in the name of Jesus Christ, but by the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Because Jesus said, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Oh. Kaya mali, huwag kayong basta papakatch yung sinasabi ng mga Protestant na, are you saved? Siyempre, hindi pa yata ako saved dahil marami akong kasalanan. We are saved. We have the chance to be saved. Okay. But again, it all comes down to the graces that we're going to accept or reject. Again, faith without works is a dead faith. Diba? Third, bumalik ulit, to be in communion with the Pope. Jesus appointed Simon Peter and his successor as the universal shepherds of this church. When he said, "You are Peter, on this rock I will build my church." Unfortunately, not all Catholics really in communion or full communion with the Pope. I heard some stories that there are certain people or group which doesn't recognize, they are part of the Catholic Church, but they don't recognize the Pope as the leader of the Church. Why? Because it doesn't conform to their policy or their needs or yung gusto nilang yung i-pursue. For example, I heard yung mga groups of people that they really want to push yung Latin Mass. Okay? There are already certain requirement for you, for those people to pursue or to celebrate Mass in Latin form. Since they don't want to follow that policy or guidelines, they don't recognize the Pope. Imagine like that. Yung aglipa, hindi pa sila full communion with the church, with the Pope. Hindi lang Aglipay, pati yung Church of Anglican. There are many mukhang Christian, mukhang Catholic, but they are not in full communion with the Church. Unfortunately. So until that time, even the Orthodox, di ba? Actually, they recognize Pope already based on the Ravenna document they sent, I think, 2007, na they recognize the Pope's supremacy. His authority. Nare-recognize nila. Ang problema nilang is yung implementing guidelines once they submit to the church again. No. Pero andyan na, at least andun na, nare-recognize na nila yung Pope supremacy. Nare-recognize na siya talagang shepherd, hindi yung mga archbishop nila. Okay? So, let's keep on praying that it will come again, na to be united again with them. Also, profess the Catholic faith in its entirety, hindi yung partial. Okay. I'm also guilty about that, di ba? Especially yung if there's something to do with ano yung mga usual cost ng division diyan. Before, guilty rin ako diyan dati, like abortion, 'di ba? We all know that abortion is evil, 'di ba? Kahit na for the sake of yung the life of the mother, the church doesn't want to do abortion. Definitely mga tungkol sa LGBTQ, etc., etc. Ang dami na kasi, LGBTQ, ganon. It's a no-no for the Catholic Church, di ba? Bawal na bawal yan. Then, a lot of people are being divided because of this issue. So, we have to be in entirety with the teachings of the Catholic Church. Pag sinabi nilang ganito, dapat embrace natin. So be part of the mission of the church. So since you are already part of the lectors and commentators, we are on service with the church. You are already part of the mission of the church. Okay? But we don't need to stop in there, diba? Remember from the start, we need to make all people as disciples of Christ, diba? So dapat gawin natin din 'yon. Whenever there's a chance, kahit pasundot-sundot lang tayo, we have to do it. So, what do you mean? Ano ba yung one true church of Christ? Ito na yan. So, we have to be one. We have to be holy. We have to be Catholic. We have to be apostolic. Yan ang characteristics of a one true church. When you say one, because only one is body of Christ. We are one body. Okay? Diba? Pag ang teaching ng Catholic Church, isa lang talaga. Pag ito, ito lang. Unlike the Protestants, sorry, ang sa kanila kasi, ang definition na minsan ng gospel sa kanila, ito, si Pastor A, iba naman kay Pastor B. So, hindi sila in sync in terms of the definition or interpretation in the Bible. Diba? May kanya-kanya sila. Although they are in one, when they say they are Protestant because they are in protest with the Catholic Church. But for us, if there's some sort of issues or confusion with in terms of the teaching of the Catholic Church, we have the synod, we have the bishops, synod of bishops to convene and resolve that matter for us. So pag yon na-resolve na nila, yun ang fina-follow natin. That's why we are one. Okay? Holy. Because we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Each one of us. Diba? And we are, through the sacraments, we become also holy. Of course, there's a sinful from time to time, yung mga behaviors natin. But we are trying to strive to be perfect. Catholic means universal. Okay? Ito yung misconfusion. Pag sinabing Catholic, hindi ka nakalagay sa Bible. Di ba? I was also guilty of this one long time ago. So now I understand better. So when you say Catholic, it means universal. Hindi lang Church of Jesus, Church of Jerusalem, Church of Roman Catholic, ganun. We are universal in every place. That's why we call it Catholic. So when you say apostolic, it because it's founded by the apostles of Christ. And there is apostolic succession. An unending apostolic succession. Okay? One time when I was in the Baptist church here in Evangelical, they also show some sort of apostolic succession with them. Sabi ko, paano mo na-prove na may ganyan yan? Because suddenly they have this yung parang apostolic succession din nila. Sabi ko, di sila naniniwala sa apostolic succession ng Catholic Church. And yet, one guy, suddenly, they created some sort of tree, like a family tree of successful apostolic succession. They believe they are the one true church already. Diba? So, what can we do? So to be more expounded this one, when you say one, the source is the Holy Trinity, founded by Jesus Christ, her soul, through the Holy Spirit, who dwells to every believer. So we are one. And ruling over the entire church, which gathers all faithful and bringing closer communion with each other. So again, we are one. Dapat isa lang tayo. One mind, one body, one spirit. Di ba? One heart also. Holy. It means we have to be in relationship with the Holy Trinity. Okay? Through our prayers, through our service to one another, di ba? Through the sacraments. So, it is created by God, led by Jesus, and guided by the Holy Spirit. So, again, relationship with the Holy Trinity. The church as the life of grace, that means we are getting this holiness from the church himself, or herself, sorry. Sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ, endowed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit, moved by charity, sinners are called to be holy. Okay? Remember, when we are here on church, we are all sinners. Okay? It is the house of sinners. Okay? Don't pretend that we are holy here. Diba? Each one of us knows our sinfulness. Diba? Kaya nga tayo struggling. Kaya minsan, hindi ako naniniwala sa inyo. Baka mas ma... Hindi, kasi I'm also a victim before. I thought he's holy because he's in service of the church. O, di ba? So, dapat, ingat tayo sa isa't isa. Sorry, ha? So, but we have, it should not stop us to be united, to be one in in communion with other, with each other, di ba? Ang pray ko nga palagi, we have to be, in spite of our differences, in spite of differing opinions, di ba, backgrounds, cultures, hopefully we'll work together as one, di ba? Since all of us are called to serve, okay? So follow the footsteps of Mary and the other saints in asking for their intercessions. Again, so we have to be holy. Again, Catholic, from the word, Greek word katholikos, which literally means all-embracing, hence universal. Christ is present in everywhere. So, wala tayong pinipili. Whether bakla, tomboy, babae, lalaki, matanda, bata, ganun. Bakla. May catch doon.
You have to say the catch.
We are all-embracing kasi that's their cross. That's their cross. What makes them sinful? Okay. Alin ba ako? Ngayon, lalaki ako. Lalaki ako. Hindi naman ako bakla, tomboy, or whatever. Non-binary. Ano ba yung mga gano'n? mga queer or whatever. Meron kasi tinatawag na non-binary ngayon eh. Bisexual. Hindi, luma na yun eh. Pero, I can be sinful. Di ba? By doing what other sinful... Ano ba yung usually yung ano? Kasalanan ng mga lalaki. Di ba? Mga pambababae, perversion, sexual perversion. Di ba?
So, hindi kasalanan maging bakla. The act
is... The act itself. Yes.
So, we have to be aware of bawal or ano...
Tinatanggap sila.
Yeah.
As long as they don't do the sexual activity.
Yeah.
Yun. The act itself. Oo. Diba? Yun yung ano yun. The problem is, they put us in front of us, love. Love is ano eh. Eh, di ba love to? I can love this one, di ba? Oh, I love my neighbor, di ba? They twisting the words, di ba? Yun yung ano doon eh. Yun yung problema, they're twisting the words. Mm. Kaya galit na galit sa akin yung kapatid ko eh. Kasi ano siya eh. ganun siya. Okay. Kaya hindi niya, pag nagsimula na ako magsalita, alis na yun. Okay. Ayun, di ba? So, it's all embracing. Catholic on the day of Pentecost until the day of Parusha. Again, the second coming of Christ. Member speaks different languages to spread the gospel. Di ba? Kaya may different liturgy. For Filipino, for English, for Romans, Catholic, Italians, Malayalam, mga ganon. Diba? Egyptian, Coptic, diba? Oh. So, take note on this one. It was controversial long time ago. It says here, there's no salvation outside the church. Extra ecclesiam nulla salus. Originally stated by Saint Cyprian, and this dogma was declared at the Fourth Lateran Council. So, pinagtibayan to. There's no salvation outside the church. Okay? Baka sabihin nyo naman sa iba, hindi kayo maliligtas, hindi kayo Katoliko. Okay? This one is for those who are already inside the church.
That's why they are telling others. Sila maliligtas kasi
nandiyan. So, hindi ibig sabihin niyan tayo lang maliligtas. Okay? But, since you're already Catholic and you go outside the Catholic Church, pwede kang tamaan ito. Because you're already inside the one true church. And yet, you reject this grace, this sanctification coming from the Holy Church. Okay? Ito, those who are born with different religion like Muslims, Protestants, Hindus, Buddhists, or mga atheists, sabi mong ganun. Atheism, di ba? They're not affected with this because God will judge them according to their heart, their works, di ba? In their love of their neighbor, di ba? Because it's not fault of their own that they were born in a different religion. Baka nga yung mga 80s na hindi naniniwala sa Diyos, sila pa mas marunong magmahal kaysa sa atin. Diba? But for us, since that's why we're doing this kind of catechesis to you guys, is to make sure you understand yung Catholic dogma, Catholic teaching. Diba? Bakit manasabing ganito? Kasi ako mismo, bakit ako lumabas sa Catholic Church? Because I don't understand. Kasalanan ko rin dahil ako, pag may nagtuturo, bata pa ako, hindi ako nakikinig, di ba? And when you grow up, and you do din research, di ba? Kahit na challenge na yung faith ninyo, and you didn't do something about it, you didn't research for that answers, di ba? It's gonna be the fault of your own. Okay? Ako, kaya nga ako naging catechist kasi na-challenge yung faith ko nung nag-aaral ako ng Arabic eh. Sinasabi niya kung ano, book of five books of Moses, blah, 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 nung Muslim na. Nag-aaral kasi ako ng Arabic. Then, sinahaluan ng kung anong klase sa Quran. So, dun ako na-challenge. Okay? Ah, sorry. Di pa pala tapos. We also need to be apostolic, di ba? Again, it is built in the foundation of 12 apostles. The witnesses chosen and sent to the mission by the Christ himself, or the keeper of the apostolic teaching, the deposit of faith. Kaya nga may mga bishops tayo because they are the replacement of the 12 apostles because they fully know the teachings of Jesus Christ. We turn to them if we're confused, di ba? If there's a miracle happen, we turn to them for validation. Yun nangyari sa Fatima, for example. In any miracles happening inside the church, they have to be validated first by the bishop of that particular area. And then it will be revalidated again by the Pope or from the Vatican office. So this apostolic succession is the unbroken chain of ordinations connecting all the bishops and the deacons and the priests ordained by them to one of the apostles in union with the successor of Peter. Hindi na pinangalang apostles kasi malilito ang tao. Meron lang 12 apostles and that's it. The next one will be called bishop. Okay? So, how can we have this communion with other people? There are 5 communions of spiritual goods. We have communion of faith. Yung mga faith natin, ito ginagawa natin. Communion of faith to. Communion of sacraments. We already talked about that. Yung mga baptism, confession, confirmation, Eucharist, communion of charisms, yung mga gifts natin. We have to share these gifts to each one of us. Baka kailangan nung technicality, yung magaling mag-speaker, magaling magbasa, magaling mag, ano po ba? Mag-video, mag-serve, anything. Okay? Or gift of healing. So we also have everything in common, like in terms of liturgy. Pag pumunta ka ng ibang lugar, punta ka ng Rome, hindi mo maintindihan yung salita, pero alam mo na ito na yung pattern ng mass. Di ba? So hindi ka malilito. Kahit mag-amen ka na lang. Pero alam mo, yun na yun. O alam mo na rin kung kakanta na sila ng Our Father. O, di ba? So mag-Our Father ka na lang in your own, di ba? So we have everything in common, yung way natin, way of life natin, di ba? Communion of charity, of course, we try to help each other. Okay. Not all of us are poor, not all of us are rich. Oh, not all of us are middle class. So everything, we have to help each other. Hindi ibig sabihin, mayaman yung isa, it doesn't need help. Okay? He might need help in other ways, in terms of prayers, in terms of emotional support. Oh, diba? Hindi mo alam ang pinagdadaanan ng bawat isa. Merong poor, they might be poor in a sense they don't have enough money, but they rich in many cases. Rich in friends, diba? Rich in relationship, diba? There are many things. So how can we exchange also spiritual goods, especially in terms of prayer? Okay. So, all of us are in one family of God. Okay. We have the intercession of saints. Kaya ito yung misconfusion with the Protestants. We pray for the saints. We pray to the saints to intercede for us, diba? So yung graces noon, hindi lang tayo nagpe-pray sa saints. So, pag nag-pray tayo sa saints, babalik sa atin. We are the communion of saints, the fellow pilgrims tayo. Yung pinipray din nila, yung mga kaluluwa sa purgatorio. Di ba? Tapos tayo, we are the church militants, we also pray to each other. So, yung graces, pabalik din sa atin. Okay? Maaring papunta sa kanila, pero actually may buhabalik din sa atin. We are also praying for the dead. Kasi the dead cannot help themselves. It's very clear, those mystical saints, that the dead people cannot help themselves. Okay? So that's why we continuously pray for them. I remember one story do sa Philippines. Pare yung anak niya. So pinag-pray niya yung mother niya. Lagi yon, every day. For 1 year. Until such time, experienced a dream. Yung mother niya nagsasabi, "Thank you, nakarating na ako sa langit." Imagine yung 1 year, every day sa mass, sinasabi niya yon. How much more kung yung iba hindi nakaka-receive ng prayer? O, di ba? Ganun katagal, 1 year. Eh, yung 1 year nila sa atin, iba yung 1 year nila. Sorry. Kasi yung sa atin, parang one day natin is around sa kanila, around 1,000 years eh. So imagine.
Kahit na iba yung salita nung namatay.
Oh, wala naman. Kasi iba na yun eh.
Lolo ko kasi.
Ah, talaga?
In-check daw kasi.
Ah, in-check. Wala. Wala ang problema yun. Ha? Tayo! Oh. In-explain ko na eh. Oh. So, it doesn't matter yung pinagpe-pray nyo is Italian, Chinese, ano, we are in communion. Kailan, if you go back to the Bible, in the Old Testaments, kailan ba nagkaroon tayong different languages, di ba? During the time yung Tower of Babel, di ba? Di ba? Kinonfuse tayo ng Diyos para talo-talo tayo. Kasi parang hindi tayo magkaintindihan. But when we pray to the Holy Spirit, di ba? Ang Holy Spirit, it's one of the gifts is the gifts of tongue. Oh, imagine, suddenly, yung isa, marunong magsalita ng ganito, ng ganyan. Oh. So, that language barrier doesn't mean anything. Baka yung dead, relative mo, naiintindihan ka na kahit Tagalog ka eh. Most likely. Sabi ko nga sa tinuturuan ko, yung lahat ng aalamin natin, hindi na tayo mag-aaral. Kasi doon, para sigurong ano eh, it's gonna be instilled to us na lang yung mga knowledge and wisdom eh. Kasi hindi na tayo mag-aaral eh. Just like the angels, they didn't study, di ba? They were gifted with knowledge and wisdom na, di ba? And they were part of the works of God when creating the earth, di ba? So Article 9, I believe in the Catholic Church and the communion of saints. So Catholics believe that the church is more than a mere institution and certainly not a necessary evil. We all know, by the way, that there was a history of anti-popes, okay? Na suddenly they declared themselves pope, okay? It happened. So because the church herself is a struggling church, but it is still holy. So nakaka-recover naman tayo. Again, the gates of hell will never prevail, sabi ni Jesus Christ. So maniwala tayo doon. So the church herself will become or will continue to become holy. So Christ explicitly uses the word ecclesia in Greek in Matthew when he says, I will build my church. So Catholic is the one true church, which is one, holy, Catholic, apostolic. Apat lang siya. One, holy, Catholic, apostolic. 10th article. So, I believe in the forgiveness of sins. So we're going to talk about the nature of sin and the power of the keys. Oh, susi. Susi. Oh, what is sin? Di ba medyo bastos yun? Okay lang. So what is sin? A sin is an act of disobedience to the commandments of God. It requires full awareness and deliberate consent. So pag sinabing sin, full awareness and deliberate. So pag accident mo na, halimbawa, nakapatay ka, pero aksidente, hindi mo naman full knowledge, hindi yun sin. Pero kawaw, mapaparusahan ka pa rin dahil sa law of man. But for the law of God, you are innocent. There's a difference, ha? Okay? Sinasadya. Hindi mo sinasadya eh, pero nakapatay ka. O nakasagasa ka, or sabihin mo hindi mo napatay, na-injured mo siya. Okay? Pero may pananagutan ka pa rin. Pero in the law of men. Okay? The first or original sin was committed by Adam and Eve, who ate the forbidden fruit. Okay? Hindi siya apple, hindi siya passion fruit, or ano man yan. Basta fruit siya. Therefore, all men are prone to commit sin. Okay. So, may sarili na kong sinfulness. May sarili, kanya-kanya kayong sinfulness. It could be something about money, fame, vanity, addiction. Ano yung isa?
Indus.
Matindi hugot ah! Oh, di ba? Magiging kasalanan palang indus. Okay. So, mag-ingat kayo sa in-laws nyo. So, again, from this first disobedience of man, it bores the original sin and it becomes so many variety of sins. Diba? Like I said a while ago. So, what are the manners of sin? Thoughts, words, actions, and omissions. Okay. Pag sinabing thoughts, yun yung mga impure desires, such as wishing evil for others, craving for other goods. Sa mga lalaki, alam mo nyo na yun. Oh, yun. Sa babae, meron din yan ngayon. Kasi mga liberated na, o di ba? Words, lying, cursing. Naku, ang dami. Patay na naman ako dyan. Such as testify falsely about our neighbors. Di ba? Nasa Ten Commandments yan.
Martes,
di ba? Sigurado yung Marites, dapat yung totoo, walang dagdag. Okay, pero pag may dagdag na, nako, patay kayo dyan, sinful na. Pero mo, kinalat nyo na, pinahiyan nyo pa, dinagdagan nyo pa. Oh. Uttering bad words also. actions, wicked acts against our neighbor, such as killing, stealing, committing adultery, di ba? So, obviously, pag sinabi mong yan, yan yung mga kasalanan. Sa Old Testament, there from Ten Commandments, there are also expounded to many other sinfulness, mga laws. Kaya ang hirap i-follow yung laws of the Jewish people, di ba? That's why, instead of magkasala ka lang ng ganito, lalong dumami kasalanan mo. Kasi ang dami yung dapat i-follow. That's why, doon na papasok yung grace, di ba? Omissions are the good deeds that we fail to do for our neighbors. So, babalik na naman doon. Such as refusing to share our blessings with the poor. Eh, kaya nyo naman, capable kang magbigay, pero hindi mo binigyan. O, di ba? Hindi ko kayo pwedeng judge. Hindi ko alam kung kailan nangyari sa inyo yan. Bahala kayo. Ayaw mo pautang. Ayaw mo pautang sa akin. O, di ba? O, yung mga ayaw magbayad. O, sila pa galit. O, di ba? O, pag sinisingil mo. O, di ba? There are two types of sin. Venial sin and mortal sin. Pag sinabi mong venial sin, these are small sins. Okay? Which is called excusable. Slightly wounds of the soul. Okay? But yung matindi is mortal sin. Serious matter with full knowledge. Kaila, ito yung criteria. Full knowledge, will and intent, and can be forgiven only through the sacraments of baptism and confession. That's why, ano ba yung ano, target kagad ng mortal sin, yung mga na-commit nyo sa Ten Commandments. Okay? Let's say stealing, pinakamadali, or adultery. So if you commit that one, definitely, may mortal sin ka. And you cannot take the Holy Eucharist. Okay. Kasi you'll be added sin to yourself, yung sacrilege, di ba? So, take care, ah. So, it is called mortal because it is deadly. It kills the soul. So, hindi na siya wound, kills the soul. Okay. Tinuturo ko ito sa ano eh. Yung, alala nyo yung sa justice, yung timbangan. Tinatanong ko yung palagi yung mga estudyante ko. So, ano mas mabigat? 1 kilo of cotton or 1 kilo of ano metal? Sabi nila, metal! Oh, eh, pares 1 kilo yun eh. Oh, let's say yung cotton is yung venial sin. Mortal sin is yung metal. So, if you accumulated yung venial sins nyo, mabigat din yun sa kalooban nyo, sa souls nyo, di ba? So, be careful also. So, yung venial sins, it can be forgiven through when we are attending the Mass. Okay? But yung mortal sin, it must go through the confession, sacramental confession. So, Jesus gave His apostles and their successors in the priesthood the power to forgive sins. So this was astonishing to be sure to the 12 humble apostles. Ito hindi nila maintindihan palagi ng Protestants eh. Therefore, did Simon and Zealot suggest that it be included in the sacrament or the sacred symbol of faith? I believe in the forgiveness of sins. Since sins are act of disobedience to the commandments of God, only God has authority to forgive sins. Hindi na, pag yung sacrament, it doesn't negate or erases yung authority of God to forgive sins. Because after all, yung sacrament itself is coming from God eh. Okay? Ito yung gift ni Jesus Christ sa atin. To be given, to give absolution to our sin. So in the Old Testament, God kept the power to forgive him, to forgive sins to himself. While in the New Testament, He entrusted it to Jesus and Jesus to the church. Kaya ito yung gift of salvation or the gift of healing that we need. Ayan o, sa John, Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When He has said this, He breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained."
O, di ba?
Malinaw yan. Ewan ko bakit nila ini-ignore to. Di ba?
Okay. Ito na yung susi. What is the power of keys? The power of keys is the power to forgive sins, which Jesus gave it to Saint Peter. Siya ang forefront. And to his successors, including bishops and priests. Kasi na-pass by, na-pass on. In Caesarea Philippi, Jesus said, I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. So malinaw yun. So may mga may policy or may guidelines yun na tuwing kailan magbibigay ng bagong law si St. Peter or should I say the Pope when he's in, for example, sitting in the Church of St. Peter. Kailan magiging effective yun at kailan hindi. Okay? St. Peter is portrayed holding two keys, silver and gold. Okay? Symbolizing the power to bind and loose on earth, yung silver, as a temporal authority, and in heaven as the yung gold spiritual authority. James said, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. O, kaya pag-pray nyo ako palagi. Okay? So, ito yung authority ng Catholic Church. Okay? Na a lot of people are trying to deny or reject it. So, oh, kina-questions nila yan eh.
Ang priest mag-confess
ko sa isa. Oh, why you can... Not only that, we call our priest father. Oh, yan. Kasi ano yan eh, nagiging literal sila in terms of the terminology. They forgot the concept or the context itself. Di ba? Can we confess our sins directly to God? If God wanted our sins to be confessed directly to Him, there was no need to send His Son to earth, nor for Jesus to give the powers of the keys to the apostles. We need to have our sins forgiven by the church for three reasons, okay? To follow the will of Jesus Christ, to be assured of forgiveness, and to be reconciled with the church. But there's nothing that will stop you to ask God for forgiveness, especially if you just committed a sin. Actually, it is encouraged. Okay? Dapat nga mag-ask ka na ng forgiveness. Huwag mo na antayin na bukas pa magko-confess ka. Kung hindi ka nakapag-confess, may nangyari sa'yo. Nadedo ka. Oh, paano na? Okay. Ang daming naliligtas na soul because of the grace, they were able to ask forgiveness to God before they die. Counted yun. Because so long that you're alive here on earth, you were able to ask forgiveness, I'm sure the mercy of God will forgive you. Okay? But may catch pa rin yun, ha? Tatandaan nyo, God is love, God is mercy, and God is justice. Okay? So may purgatorio ang nag-aantay sa inyo. But at least, you are saved. Di ba? Because in hell, wala na. Ang gandong ka na lang, di ba? That's your end of story. So again, to follow Jesus, the will of Jesus, it is Jesus who instituted the sacrament of baptism for the forgiveness of sins and that the penance for sins committed thereafter, yung confession. Of course, to be assured of forgiveness, Jesus instituted baptism and penance also assure the repentant sinner for forgiveness and salvation. Especially for those who have committed serious crimes, di ba? Yung mga mortal sins. For those who are in the threshold of death, absolution or pardon of temporal punishment, di ba? Naalala mo ni yung isang inano namin ni sister eh, yung Egyptian, even though he undergo the sacrament confession, dahil yung sa sins niya towards his mother, hindi pa rin niya mapatawad ng sarili niya. Sabi ko, you have to heal yourself. You have to forgive yourself. And you already go to the confession. So God already forgive you. what you're doing now is actually insulting the gift of God. You're insulting. Nangyari na yan sa instance doon na nabasa ko kay Padre Pio. You're already yung madre, kahit na nag-undergo siya sa sacrament confession, hindi pa rin niya mapatawad or feeling guilty pa rin siya. Ano sabi ni Padre Pio? You're insulting the grace of God. Okay, so you have to forgive yourself. Yung mga kasalanan, wala na. Tapos na. During the time of exorcism, okay, ang demonyo, if you're part of the group who are exorcising some evil demon, if so happen na naging part ka ng group at you didn't purify yourself, meaning you didn't go for confession, kitang-kita ng demonyo kung anong kasalanan nyo. Oh, nakita kita, nakakaw ka. Kasi he will try to dissuade you, demoralize you, not to pray and help other people. Pero pag if you undergo the confession, wala siya makita. So yun yung power and gift of confession. So clear. So when you're not accepting that gift, you're offending, you're insulting God, the gift of God. Okay? So the absolution there is complete. Okay? And it's effective. Okay? So the third is to be reconciled with the church. Of course, you wounded yourself, you wounded others. Our sins have a negative impact on the community. Therefore, we need to be reconciled not only with God, but also with the church or the community himself, represented by the priest. Okay? So maybe it's not literal sense yung community kasi mamaya, hindi ka naman taong simbahan. But yung community na sinasabi dito, which is also part of the church, yung families mo, yung office mates mo, or yung community or neighbor mo. So you have to be reconciled on that one. Okay? That's why you have to undergo this kind of confession. Okay? So Article 10, I believe in the forgiveness of sins. Christ came to save the world from sin. Believe in the forgiveness of sin, essential to Christianity. Catholicism believes sins are forgiven in the baptism and the sacrament of penance. So, again, linawin ko lang, hindi ibig sabihin, magpa-baptize na lang ako para hindi na ako mag-confess. Hindi, one time lang ang baptism. Okay? Otherwise, if you do it again, you are committing, ano yung tawag doon, bro? Pag nagpa-baptize ka ulit.
Sacrilegion.
Mm. One time lang effective 'yon. Yung effectivity na is eternal, okay?
Pero ito bakit lang kita bro. Pero kapag halimbawa na binyagan kayo ng Catholic. Tapos nagpabinyag kayo sa ibang denomination. Pag bumalik ka sa Catholic, hindi na kayo bibinyagan. Kira-rate nyo lang yung catechism ninyo. Yung doctrines, ito. Tapos, tsaka sasabihin, tsaka kayo magpo-confess at sasabihin ng pare na pwede na kayo tumanggap ng communion.
Paano kung yung, hindi denomination? Alba, Islam or Muslim?
Kapag Islam, conversion yun.
Conversion talaga. So baptism ulit.
Ibabaptize siya. Kasi wala siyang Catholic baptism.
Ah, okay. Kasi sa Muslim, i-deny nyo yung isa sa mga kwan nyo, profession of faith sa kanila, i-deny nyo yung divinity of Jesus Christ na hindi siya son of God. Ah, yun. Tapos may babatuin mo yung wall. May gaganon kayo na tinatatwa nyo yung demonyo at dinidenay nyo rin si Christ, ganun. Kasi si Christ sa kanila is only a prophet. Pero si Muhammad, mas higher prophet. Ganun sa kanila. Okay. Oh, 11 and 12. Eschatology. We talk about dead, judgment, purgatory, hell, resurrection, paradise. Hit it. Oh, sige na, bilis. Hindi, ulitin mo. Ulitin mo, ayusin mo. Kantahin mo.
to do, do you like the things that's like?
Oh, ayan. Yeah. Diba?
Tama na!
Tama na! So, do you know where you're going to, di ba? Kasi ginawa niya yan sa ano namin eh, symposium namin eh. So, if Jesus has not risen, we will not, or is not, had not risen, we will not rise from the grave, just like Him. And St. Paul says, our faith will be in vain. So, kalokohan lahat tong ginagawa natin, in short. Kapag hindi naman si Jesus the Christ from the grave. Okay. So if Christ be not risen again, then our preaching is in vain and your faith is also in vain, 'di ba? Because for us we will rise in glory with Christ. We will ascend with Christ and we will sit with Christ at the right hand of the Father. Kasi makakasama nga natin si Christ. Yun ang reason why we're followers of Christ. So in short, ito yung tinatawag na flowchart of our life after death, di ba? So now, andito tayo. Particular judgment. So after dying, or after death, our soul will separate from our body. Will return to dust, okay? So, tatlo lang pupuntahan natin. Paradise, purgatory, or hell. Okay? Depende sa, ano natin, what do you call that one? Status natin here on earth. Yung ginawa natin ang mga behaviors, activities, how we love our neighbors, diba? How we serve others, how we pray to God, our relationship to God, di ba? So, afterwards, ito yan. During the time of universal judgment, it depends, di ba? Some of us already dead, let's say, namatay, kamamatay lang. Okay, some of them are still alive, will be judged according again to our heart, di ba? It is given to all men after resurrection. So, again, tatlo lang ang pupuntahan natin. Paradise or hell. At saka purgatory actually. Dapat yan. So, during that time, those just people who are going to heaven, they will have a glorified body. So, we will be reunited with our body. Whether binaon niya sa lupa, cremate ka, or tinapong ka sa tubig. Ayun. Kinain ka ng ano.
Scatter.
It doesn't matter. Kahit scatter ka.
It says there.
It says there. Pero, let's say,
resurrection of
the body. Oh, it doesn't matter. Let's say, ano lang naman no, kailangan hindi is scattered for giving reverence to the body. Oh. And let's say, ikaw namatay, kinirimate kita, hawak-hawak kita. Kunyari lang! Oh, hawak-hawak kita. Oh, bigla ako napatid. Ay, so! Oh! Sorry! Oh, it doesn't matter. Oh, di ba? Oh, kaya, nakanga nga yung isa, nanunok pa niya. Oh, ano mangyayari? So, it doesn't matter. God has a way to reunite our bodies to become a glorified body later on during the time of the second coming. Okay. So don't worry. Let the dead bury their dead, sabi nga ni Jesus Christ, di ba? So, after all, God will find a way for us to be resurrected. So what is resurrection? The resurrection is the act by which God gives eternal life to our mortal bodies and reunites them with our souls. So the resurrection is different from resuscitation. Gaya na sinabi ko, yung nangyayari kay the daughter of Jairus, di ba? Which act by which the mortal body is reunited with the soul, such in the case of
Lazarus at saka si Jairus, yung the daughter of Jairus. Okay? So, ito yung resurrection, ito yung resuscitation. Okay? Okay, yung mga naririnig natin story na biglang bumalik, namatay na for couple of minutes, tapos bumalik, di ba? Resuscitation yun. Okay? Okay. Beatic vision. Yung mga nurse dyan, yan, yung mga doktor, ha? What is the beatic vision? The beatic vision is the contemplation of God in His heavenly glory. We cannot imagine the bliss and splendor of paradise, lest we die for yearning. What we know is that we will be in the presence of God. So some of us have this kind of imagination. They have great imagination of the vision in heaven. So when will resurrection will happen? The resurrection will take place at the end of times, after the second coming of Christ and before the final judgment. All men will rise from dead and the end of the world. Those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, but those who have done wicked deeds will be in the resurrection of condemnation. Nakaw. So at the end of times, all men will be resurrected and their risen bodies will be reunited again to their souls kahit nagkalat ng abo mo dyan. Okay? Yeah. I would like to emphasize this beatific vision kasi most of us are so distracted in our everyday life. Diba? Naalala nyo yung last kong session with you na they don't have even those souls in the purgatory, in the highest level of purgatory, they stop there or they stuck in there because they don't have that desire to go to heaven. They're stuck there because they don't have that beatific vision to be with God, to be with Him, di ba? Now, ito, I just included this one. Fiction story lang to na pinapanood ko ngayon, The Sandman sa Netflix, di ba? Ang scene ito is that The Sandman is yung what we call dream, yung one of the endless, or what he's called also Lord Morpheus. Tinatry niyang kunin yung helm niya as part of his tools in using the dream world. Eh, nakuha siya nung one of the demons of Lucifer. So, ngayon, alam mo naman, paano makipagdilang demons, you have to have deal. So, kailangan may duel muna mangyari bago niya makuha yung helm niya. So, in short, nanalo naman siya sa duel. Kahit na ang kalaban niya sa mismo, si Lucifer. Nakakatuwa nga yung laban pag napanood niyo eh. Kasi ang pinanlaban niya last time, who can kill hope? Hope ang sinabi, I am hope, sabi niya. Pero after winning that duel, ang sinabi niya kay Lucifer, you really indeed honorable. Sabi, honorable? Sabi niya ganon. Why do you say I'm honor? Are you joking? So, why do you think we will let you go in these lords of devil? Sabi niya ganon. Anong sabi niyang ganun? Anong sabi pa ni Lucifer, you have no power here, sabi niya, kay Dream. Ang sabi naman ni Dream, you say I have no power here. Perhaps you speak truly. But to say dreams have no power in hell. Tell me, Lucifer, Morning Star, what power would hell have if those here imprisoned were not able to dream of heaven? Yun ang sinabi niya. Yun lang ang sinabi niya at pinakwalan siya ni Lucifer. Bakit? Takot si Lucifer na hindi mag-dream niyong mga fellow devils niya about heaven. Which struck me. Bakit? Naalala ko yung part sa Book of Enoch. Ang sabi niya, nung pumunta si Enoch sa heaven, pati sa hell, eto yung sinabi daw, then I went and spoke with them, yung what we call the watchers,
yung mga fallen angels that they have a sexual encounter with the daughters of men na nagkaroon ng anak, naging Nephilim, yon. And they were all afraid and fear and trembling seized than them. They besought me to draw up a petition for them. Ito kasi yung sinasabi, that they might find forgiveness and to read their petition in the presence of the Lord of Heaven. Even the fallen angels are dreaming of forgiveness and to come back in heaven. So imagine, even the devils themselves or the fallen angels are dreaming to go back in heaven. Unfortunately, negative yung reaction ni God sa kanila o yung reply ni God sa kanila. Their verdict is final, unfortunately. For us here, as long as we're here on earth, and we're able to find forgiveness from God, and ask for forgiveness from God, we can be assured to go to heaven. So, yan. Kaya ako sinama yan. So, we have to have this kind of desire to go to heaven. This beatific vision. Diba? Hindi lang dahil wala ng sufferings and then, okay na ako dito. I don't want to go to heaven na because I don't have sufferings na. Yeah. So we have to have this kind of vision to us. What is the new heaven and earth? After the universal judgment, the righteous will reign forever with Christ, with the glorified body and soul. So, may mangyayari pa. So, magkakaroon ng new heaven and earth. The universe itself will be renewed. So, mababago na lahat. It will be the definitive realization of God's plan to bring under a single head all things in Christ, things in heaven and earth, or things in heaven and things on earth. Those who are united with Christ will form the community of the redeemed. So imagine kung masama tayo dyan. Will be part of the holy city of God, di ba? The bride, the wife of Lamb. God opens himself in an inexhaustible way to the elect, will be the ever-flowing wellspring of happiness, peace, and mutual communion. So, wala na. Lahat na tayo, magkakabati na tayo. Wala nang away-away. So, the world itself restored to its original state, facing no further obstacles, should be at the first service of the just. Okay. So, yung pre-original sin, babalik na tayo doon. We will have a glorified body, we'll have harmony, not only with fellow human beings, but also with animals. Diba? Sharing the glorification and the reason of Jesus Christ. So, Article 11 and 12. I believe in the resurrection of the body. From the Catholic perspective, a human body is a union of body and soul. So, death is just the momentary separation of body and soul until in the end of the world. So, yung mga nauna na sa ating namatay, they still don't have that glorified body until the second coming of Christ, the general judgment or universal judgment, and the resurrection of the dead. So the just go body and soul into heaven, and the damned go body and soul into hell. Nakunsaklap naman nun. Pag nakabasa kayo with regards to the description of purgatory and hell, baka matakot na kayo. As Christ... In Article 12, life everlasting, as Christ our Savior died, so too must mere mortals. So, namatay nga si Christ, so tayo, dadaan din tayo doon. As He rose, He shall all human beings. Death is the only way to the cross from this life into the next. At the very moment of death, private judgment occurs. So, papakita yon. Ano lang yun, pag sinaming private judgment between you and your judgment. Pag sa general judgment kasi, ipapublic yon na lahat ng tao nandoon. So, it's particularly holy and virtuous. The soul goes directly to heaven. Okay. So, we can compare this in the parable of the barren fig. Diba? Barren fig tree. Sabi doon na yung sinabi ni Jesus Christ, "For 3 years, I have come looking for fruit on this fig tree. And still I find none. Cut it down. Why should be wasting the soil?" Diba, merong story rin doon na antagal na nag-antay sa atin ng Diyos na to become fruitful, to become productive here on earth. Once the time na sinabi na ng Diyos, call, sino magkakall ko? pag sinabi niya, call Tere, call Kurt, wala na, patay na, at hindi kami nagbago, sorry na lang. Ganon. So, hanggang doon na lang. So, it's either we go to heaven, purgatory, or hell. So, while we're still here on earth, while we're still young and we're able, we try to give service to God. Diba? So, one thing which depletes the soil, ano na natin to, wag na natin masyadong, ano, masyadong pag-usapan. Pero, ang point here is that we try to make sure that each minute of our life, each hour, each second, we try to be good and become charitable to one another. Okay? It also, we can relate this one, this creed, to the parable of talents. Ito, palagi ko iniisip to eh. Once, every time na sinasabi sa gospel reading. Okay? Ano yung sinabi nung lazy na servants? Master, yung binigyan ng coins, di ba? Just to keep short. Master, I knew you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid. I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours. But his master replied, you wicked and lazy slave. Did you, that I reap where I did not sow and gather with where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return, I will have returned what was on my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. From those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, and where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. So, this is two ways. Yung material gift na meron tayo, kaya maraming naghihirap sa Pilipinas kasi yung iba, kaya naman nila, may talent naman sila, pero tamad lang talaga sila. Ano nangyayari sa kanila? Kahit yung kakonti na lang meron sila, nawawala pa sa kanila. Kasi nga, tamad sila. Oh. And the second part is yung gift natin, if we do not share these spiritual gifts with other people, it can be taken away from us. Diba? Kaya nga yung gifts of the Holy Spirit, kahit yung sinasabi nilang gifts of tongue, kailan ba lumalabas yun? Pag kailangan lang. Diba? Yung gift of healing, gift of prophecy, yung knowledge and wisdom. If we don't perform our duty and use these talents, it will be taken away from us also. Diba? Yung sample nito, in practical and scientific term, sabi sa National Geography na channel, yung one rule ng brain natin. Kasi yung mga talents natin nandito sa head natin. Diba yung mga cells? The more the cells is binding together or spinding or a spider of connections, the more it is intact or usable. Let's say one part of the cell is something to do with the musical talents. Example, if you don't use it, yung cells na yon namamatay, nawawala, napuputol. Once naputol pala yon, sabi doon, once you lose it na. Yung connection na yon. Yun yung totoong nangyayari sa brain natin. So may katotohanan talaga to.
Namatay yung cells ko sa pagkanta.
Okay?
Sabi ko lang iniisip yun eh.
So habang may connection pa, gamitin nyo na. Okay?
Kaya ako napunta sa lecture eh.
Mapapractice.
Namatay pala yung cells ko sa pagkanta.
So, we can also relate this one. We can also relate this one in the parable of the true vine, which is Jesus is the true vine, di ba? Just as a branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine,
Diba? Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit. Because apart from me, you can do nothing. So kahit na ikaw pinakamagaling na teacher, ikaw na pinakamagaling na preacher, pinaka-wise, knowledgeable, if you're not abiding to Christ, okay, you're not relying on Christ, bali wala yan. You will not bear much fruit. Kukunti lang fruit ano, mangyayari sa inyo. So we have to be part of Jesus Christ. We have to rely on Him, on His grace, di ba? So that us, through Christ, will be also be glorified. So the key for fruitfulness is to abide in our Lord Jesus Christ, our relationship to Him, through union and faith drawn from the source. Sino ba yung source? Si God the Father, di ba? Well, we have to keep His commandments, okay? Even though it's hard to follow His commandments, we have to strive to follow that one. Through the grace, we'll be able to do it. Yeah, we have to love one another. Oh, not in, alam niyo na yun. Okay? In a friendly way, okay?
Love your neighbor.
Although, yung part na yun is one of the hardest thing to do. Di ba? You have, lalo na kung hindi mo kilala, di ba? So, using greed as a model of our fruitfulness. So, with the greatest among you will have to be the servant. Diba? Those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and all who humble themselves will be exalted. Parang yan yung ano, ha? Gospel kanina. Ha? So, the Luke said, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send more laborers. Kaya nga, kailangan natin mag-gather for ng mga disciples of Christ. So be, again, key for fruitfulness, be servant to all. Use our gifts for the community and the church. Ayun. So ito pa, again, in Peter, you must take every effort to support your faith with goodness, with knowledge, knowledge with self-control, self-control with endurance, endurance with godliness, then godliness with mutual affection, then mutual affection with love. So, in the end, love pa rin. Diba? Then, keep you from being ineffective and unfruitful with the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, ibig sabihin, kailangan mag-aral kayo. Diba? And be all eager to confirm your call and election for this. For if you do this, you will be never stumbled. From time to time, natatalo pa rin ako ng kwan, yung kaibigan o ka-office mate kong Protestants. Kasi talaga nag-aaral siya. Oo, matindi. Siya, kabisado niya yung Bible. Ako, hindi. Ganun sila katindi, di ba? So, key for fruitfulness again, goodness, knowledge, self-control, perseverance, godliness, brotherly kindness, then love again. Okay? So, etong mga fruitful of the Spirit, you have love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. So, pag yan may nangyayari na sa inyo, ibig sabihin, may nangyayari sa ginagawa ninyo. Kung isa man dyan, dalawa, tatlo, apat, o lahat yan nangyayari sa inyo, nagiging productive kayo. Okay? Kasi, again, the model of the creed, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up your cross. Remember what I said, each one of us has his own cross. Can be bigger, smaller, longer, mataba, payat, ganun. Pero, this is according to our own self. Because each one of us are unique, di ba? Maaring yung cross ko, mukhang magaan sa inyo, pero mabigat sa akin. Yung cross mo mukhang mabigat para sa akin, pero pag sa'yo, napakagaan. So, each one of us is designed with own cross, di ba? Can be our friends, our family, relatives, neighbors, in-laws, di ba? Children, di ba? Neighbor, ganun. Our boss. Let's go. So, our baptism means new life and responsibility. We'll be born again through water and spirit, being crucified. Ayan. So, ano na tayo dito?
We need everyday conversion. Okay? So, we need to subordinate our will to God's will, keep the commandments, go to the sacrament of reconciliation or confession. Okay? Sabi ni Jesus, we must be perfect or strive to be perfect and seek to be more like them every day in everything we do, think, and say. Okay? We try to imitate Jesus and Mary, their kindness, mercy, and love. Of course, temptation is our weaknesses. Okay? We struggle with our sin, saying, I do not understand my own accords. I keep on saying also that one. For I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate, which is the sin. Diba? Nangyari yan. Aminin nyo man o hindi. If we intend to reach heaven, we need to live our lives in search of holiness every day and to make our quest for holiness an hour on the Sunday. And consider spending our time. Kung ano ba yung ginagawa natin? Is it making us holy or making us sinful, di ba? Like even watching TV. Whether it's Korean novela yan, or si Darna, o si... Buhay pa ba si Provinciano? Patay na. Tapos na. Ay, tapos na rin. Ha? May nila na? Okay, ha? So, is that making ourselves holy? Yung ginagawa natin dito, is that's yung holy? Yung pagiging marites natin, does it make us holy? Or are we helping other people because of being marites? Or being, ano ba yun sa? Si Karen? sa ano yun? Sa US yun eh. Diba? So we should not love anything of this world more than we love God. So we have to detach ourselves. So ito yung sinabi ni Jesus. Ito yung sum up ng everything na commandments, diba? You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. Actually, kulang yan. With all your strength. Diba? You shall love, and the next one is you shall love your neighbor as yourself. If you do this, malamang cover nyo na lahat ng commandments. Diba? So, our daily conversion should let us learn how to love God every day and to love God with our brothers and sisters. Love like Christ loved. Naku, mahirap yan. Again, yung work, corporal works of mercy. We also have the spiritual works of mercy. Huh? Conversion of our intellect was not enough. Okay? If our will was not completely subject to God, we are in peril. Okay? So we have keep on feeding our appetites with spiritual things, a spiritual goodness. So we have to get rid of ourselves of our old life or our former ways, di ba? Kasi nga dapat we are new in Christ na. So, ang magagaling dyan yung mga Protestants eh. So, our creed teaches us about the blessed faith in Trinity. In summary, faith in the Catholic Church. And in short, also talks about the redemptive work of Christ. That talks about the holy sacraments. Talks about the it's supposed to be universal judgment, hell and purgatory. Also, we also talk about a particular judgment. And also, once we do all this, we'll be fruitful and our conversion will be complete. Okay? So, ito yung scripture proofs related to the Apostles' Creed. Ito yung mga other references I get into this one article. So, that's it. Any questions? Oh, init.